You know, when the kids were younger and Grace and John were, you know, when the kids were younger and Grace and John were fighting, at one point, I gave them two knives and said, go ahead and kill yourself.
I never peeped. I did have a thing when I was going to school there, because I'll admit I wasn't exact. I'm not the healthiest guy. I had issues. But there was, we were in Cambridge, Mass, at a place that would be unprohibitively expensive now, but it was owned by the school. There was a building right across from us, and there was a family in the building, and there was a, I don't know, older, I'm going to say she was in her 20s, this girl, and they wouldn't put the curtains down, and I would just be waiting for the girl to take her, you know, to undress for the night, and I mean, that's terrible, but I did spend a lot of hours looking over there. You know, you just sit there for hours, you're going like, oh, okay, come on, please, 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 please.
On the side of caution when she's joking around a 16-year-old girl, I mean, that's just obviously ridiculous, no?
What is being cautious with a 16-year-old?
Yeah, I mean, we're two girls. I mean, like, the fact that
okay, if we were talking, they could talk about, like, is penis size important? Let's just say, right?
Ben, well, shut the fuck up.
You'll say this is provocative. I think a lot of the sexual predator priest stuff is overblown. I think a lot of those
Mike,
kids were
you
gay
Catholic?
Kids.
Well, not, so I think you're
yeah,
not,
I
bro.
Think 14-year-old whores who go on a mingle and are hoping to see a penis deserve to an encounter.
I do think women are largely whores, but I wouldn't speak from my own experience. I've had several homosexual encounters, but I've not had any gay sex. Yeah. I got somewhat molested by a beautiful girl when I was visiting my friend Joe Shabatoni.
Doc,
I loved it. I mean, she was beautiful. I think of the fondling.
Are you trying to say you got molested by a younger woman? Did you just
no?
Say
she
that?
Was old. She was old. His older sister. She was gorgeous.
Joe Shabatoni.
And his mother sort of agreed with him. It was crazy. Totally crazy. Nothing to do with YouTube.
Oh, yeah.
He found some, whatever, you know, this is when his mother was, I mean, this isn't really like YouTube, right? So he went through, he was convinced of this somehow. I think his mother was telling him. So he went through his sister's phone and she sent me something, you know, a teenage girl will send something. Maybe it was an emoji of a...
I think eggplant. Phrase it was, really hey, can that. You come up here and bring that big dick with you? And
yeah, right.
Plant emojis?
Yeah.
I have no memory, I don't know.
Saying, I think I'm the most sexually normal guy in the world. I was told, I have someone who goes to my chat who's a 16-year-old girl, and I was told, like, it's really, really a problem. I was like, what would be the problem? I chat with her, I would... meet her in person. I would tell a 6-year-old girl that her dress looked pretty.
Ben.
I'm a pedophile in the Greek sense, Mike. Lover of children. I love children, especially girls.
Oh, Ben.
I love children, especially little girls.
I think you should be less ambiguous about that.
And I like to, I guess you could call it flirting, flirt with little girls and say, like,
nope.
How pretty they look.
I don't like that.
Oh, I think that's your problem, guys. A normal man loves to flirt with a little girl and say,
flirt with little girls, you fucking
what is wrong
tar.
With him?
It depends what you mean by flirt, but yeah, like flirt. Yeah, like say, like, aren't you a pretty little girl? Oh, my kids were little. I very much loved their little bodies, and I pinched their butts and all that stuff. That was very touchy-feely. I think you're crazy if you're not, but I'm not.
Man, we really, I think we found a winner, guys. I think we found our next season. Oh, man. Jesus. We need to get the dad in orbit too. I'm sure he'd probably join, I imagine. This clip of him and Erudite?
Hold everybody.
Do you don't need to be here if you don't want to be a part of this conversation.
What's your problem? Why are you coming on here scolding everybody?
Chill out, Ben. Chill
if you,
out.
I'll say again, if you don't want to be funny. Here, you're welcome to leave. You don't have to be.
Yeah, you're welcome to leave too.
Chill out, Ben.
Alex, I demand my rights.
Okay, he's trolling. He's trolling.
The whole point.
Invited Kyla. Just take it easy. Go ahead.
Kay. I'm just kidding with you, Kyla or Kayla, whatever your name is.
Okay. The whole point that I'm trying to get at is the concern of emphasis. For women, my frustration with women and Yas Queen girl group is when we talk about sexual assault, we just want to talk about how dirty, pig-headed, gross men do sexual assault. And that's about the end of the conversation. When a really important part about the conversation are things like, how do we make our cues more explicit so that situations that are messy and like unclear consent leads to somebody, women, when we're, that you them not-
Hi, everybody who sits here.
But I think, okay.
Yeah, you can go ahead. I'm on stream, just so you know.
Make a quick point, and we'll bounce it around. That's how guys talk.
All right, chill out. I don't think that, though, we can right away assume...
Am I right, science book?
...that he was being predatory. It's probably possible that he was being a predator, right? I'm not saying that's impossible, but it's also possible
like you're losing that he
legitimately did not know any better.
I'm sorry, I'm, like, going down this rabbit hole now. They're all playing characters?
This is the point. The point is, you guys are kind of right. There is something incestuous going on, all right? It's true. If you're a girl and you're not connected to your dad, you need to go find your dad and suck his dick.
Okay, maybe some of these are like... trolling? What is... Okay, we might just watch this whole video. Jesus Christ. Maybe they mean, like, metaphorically. It's 2 hours long. Well, I need to go hang out with Dan the Man. Bring her on again? Well, I don't even know what we're talking about next. I feel like we gotta get her dad on, too. But I feel like that her dad probably explains a lot of... Her. That's probably how children normally work, huh? She just ended her stream and said she can explain everything about her family to whomever is interested. She should have met me before the Max arc, because before the Max arc, I would have had a lot of charitability for kind of weird situations like this, but I'm probably pretty dry right now on... be charitable for this kind of stuff.
Ben Thorpe is a 51-year-old man who hails from Portal to Hell, an incest capital of the United States, Rhode Island. 7 months ago, in 2022, Ben decided to turn himself, wife, daughter-wife, and 5 children into YouTube content.
5 children.
Since selling his property in 2019, Ben has burned through $600,000, leaving only a bit over $100,000 left for his family that have no jobs. His wife has left him. And his children now have a permanent reminder in the future to watch how he burned down their lives. Welcome to the wild Thorpeberries.
Holy shit.
Really like dominating a woman.
Right.
Like, I don't really like beating the shit out of a woman. I don't like it. I had to correct Grace today, like very roughly by like...
You know, really? You gave Honey Bunch a real through, yeah.
Oh, she could be like so Honey crazy Bunch, she gets that. It from her mother, right? At the core of marriage, you moron.
Giving?
Alright, fuck you. Fuck you, may you rot in hell for saying that. Fuck you!
I don't know. I think the core of marriage is two souls coming together as one.
Yeah. I tell you, way, way back, you know, and I'm not saying I'm her husband. I wasn't. It was a mistake. But way, way back, she was in the car with me before any kids were involved. Yeah. She was saying, am I the prettiest girl? Am I the prettiest girl? And I said, I've got an answer for that. I pulled over the car to the side of the road. We were on a highway at a rest stop. I took her down to the trees. I took my belt off, and I didn't beat the shit out of her. But
well,
I was
that's
like,
good. Your good. Answer, good. Right?
The point, okay? And I don't know what I'm... So this is the point. The point is, you guys are kind of right. There is something incestuous going on, all right? It's true.
If you're a girl and you're not connected to your dad, you need to go find your dad and suck his dick.
Humiliating.
can go get the boys over here, right? That's your job, bitch. Hit the streets and bring back some customers. Am I right?
Hollywood Benthorpe. My ex Hollywood Benthorpe. It's just like, it's just, it's coming.
Ow! Fucking bitch. Get up. My scream!
Okay. That was a.
Gang banged, and I want slurp cock and have cum all over my face.
This one ever had a gas leak?
I'll refer you to my first supercut on the Thorpes here, and leave a link in the description if this is your first time hearing of them. I want to pick up around where that left off for December 28th, 2022. John Thorpe, Ben's son, appeared on a few of the Thorpe streams prior to this. However, it was actually Ben forcing his son onto these streams at the time, threatening his living situation. At this time, John had just had knee surgery and was on crutches when he decides to confront his father in a call.
Right, okay, so you guys have a problem. Why aren't you working
together? No, we don't have a problem. They have a problem, and you do too. It's called stupidness, and you all have it.
John, don't you think you could get a wheelchair?
What are you talking about?
A wheelchair is what I'm
talking about. Why would I get a wheelchair? I can walk around with crutches. I just can't do anything, really.
Why not?
Because I can't bring something from one area to another with crutches.
Oh my god.
There's nothing to fucking eat up there anyways. You need somebody to like help you if you're using crutches. You need somebody around you. Nobody like uses crutches by themselves.
Well, John, can you sit in a chair? I mean, you're telling me
you don't even know what you're talking
about.
You don't do anything. All you do is sleep all day. You just sit in your bed laying down like a loser. I move more than you at this point, even though I have a leg injury. You don't even move, and you're a fully functional adult.
You won't let me talk. This is John, your sister Grace is available. She's nimble.
Yeah, I'm not gonna ask you guys to do that stuff. Because you're gonna just use it as a power game, because that's all you guys do. It drives me crazy. All you did from the first second that I got this leg injury was use it as a power game against me, and I hate it.
The point John is making about everything turning into a power game is a great point. Because of Ben seeing Courtney and John, his wife and son respectively, as the enemy, every conversation or interaction that I've ever seen them have has been some type of power game, whether it's to gain something or to manipulate them or to embarrass them. There's always a power game going on.
That's why all a power trip for you guys. Look, I'll dangle this in front of your face the entire time. Look, I'll dangle food in front of you. Look, I'm dangling this stuff in front of you.
Anything in front of you?
I'm not doing that game. I'd rather starve than play into your little power game where I have to say sorry all the time, or you're gonna like not feed me.
John, you said
you're wrong. John, what the fuck?
You don't
fuck
give me any
is,
food when
no,
you come up here.
No.
You gave me brownies
John,
that were left over last time.
What the fuck is wrong with you?
I don't get any food.
What the fuck is wrong with you? Why are you such an asshole all the time?
How am I an asshole all the time? You don't even talk to me.
Why don't
you cry? All you do is cry and make weird comments on the YouTube channel about how I suck dick or whatever. That's what you're
Isn't it funny that your knee injury? Where'd you get that from?
It's like the most cringy comments ever, and nobody laughs. Nobody laughs. Have you ever noticed that nobody thinks you're that funny? You're not really a funny guy. You're like annoying.
Okay, John.
I don't know what this whole like. Oh, let's fix you now, buddy. Like I don't need your help in any way. You don't help me. You never helped me. You always just have been sitting on the sidelines like a retard, waiting for other people to like complain.
John, What I'm saying is Grace complaining
before I got the leg injury. I was getting myself food. I was feeding your children. You treat your daughter like your mommy. Is that nice? Baby
John,
boy.
You want a sandwich. Like the way you're talking to me. Stop. Stop talking John, to me like that.
John, you would
you
like to get...
I hate you.
Nobody likes your dynamic together. You suck. You're, like, just depressing to watch.
Grace, John's sister, is 10 feet beneath him and can get him a sandwich.
No, you can't. You use that as a game. I'm not playing that game. Where else am I getting food? Nobody's getting fed up here. Like, why don't you just not come up here then? Like, I don't even know why you're coming up here. That's not the deal, that you get to come up here at 4 a.m., 5 a.m., 6 a.m., 3 p.m., and you don't give anybody food except yourself, and you're selfish.
John,
that's what's going on. You get to come up here and ruin everybody's time whenever you come up here.
Shut up.
Come up here 7 times a day. And then at midnight, and then at 3 a.m., and then at 6 a.m., and then at 8 a.m., and then at 12 p.m., and like every second of the day, you're gonna eat. What is wrong with you and not offer anybody food? Ridiculous.
John, I never go up there. Is that correct?
Yeah, I know, because you're a weirdo. You don't even have your children.
John, you told me that if I enter those premises, you have.
No, I never said that to you.
By calling the police on me.
If you're gonna threaten to kick me out, unfairly, just because you felt like it, because you think that you have this upper hand. You're getting a good deal up here, if anything. I'm paying half your rent, and you're not doing anything for it except having two of your children live up here tormenting me. That's not a very good deal for me.
Where are the other children?
I don't know why I have to be so incredibly grateful for it. It's like very, like, I have no independence. I'm like living at home still. That's why it's like, what is so great about, like, living here?
Do you not
think? It's basically just living at home, but without the support of your, like, mother if you get injured.
Correct?
No, I'm a victim of your situation that you forced me to be in, yeah.
Me, you're a victim of Grace, you're a victim of your two brothers who are
your
roommates.
Yeah, but it all comes down to you.
Who aren't you?
You're the biggest guy ever. You suck. I think
I'm
you
a great
failed
guy. Yeah, you're
so
wrong.
Many
I'm
times
a great guy.
Fail. You act like you're not. It's not even just that, because I don't have a problem with people who fail. I really actually respect the, like, Abyssinia thing. I know you think I hate you for that, but I respect that you did that. I respect a lot of things that you've done, but you're just the relationship that you have with me throughout that whole thing. Thank you, man. I love you. Such a great dad.
Yeah, I am
yes,
a great dad.
Everybody should be grateful to you, because you're the God of everybody. Everybody should be grateful to you.
Everybody should say sorry to you, too.
Including random internet people like the Ortho Bro. He should say sorry to you and that he's so sorry. I'm so sorry for what I've done to you. What did he do to
you?
Sucked. You have to. That's why you don't have any friends, because you think everybody owes you something.
John says you should take a
John, I
got you. Not everybody owes you something, Benny boy. Maybe you owe some people some things, and you don't give them anything.
Hey, buddy, be super respectful to me. What is there here that I'm supposed to respect? You're an insolent fucking asshole.
You don't respect me at all. I don't have to give you that
what
much respect.
What is there worthy of respect
you
here?
As my father, if you don't give me any respect as even a person.
What is there that you're doing that is worthy of respect?
Why? And you're a loser.
Oh, that's such a weird thing. Holy shit. Did anybody? It's like that's the Steven Crowder line, right? Are you even worthy of being a wife?
I'm not. How about that? That's a loser thing to do. Just sit in bed all day.
Call back.
Having your daughter bring you food.
Or call forward. Prediction,
crying,
I guess.
Lying on internet streams about how much you hate her. Okay, guy. We get it. You're the traditional man. You've won in life. No, you suck.
I'm winning.
Your whole, like,
I'm winning.
Program.
I'm winning even more. And you should join my team, because what you're doing sucks.
You're not a winner, Ben. Benny boy, you're not a winner. You're a loser.
You shouldn't refer
you've
to
lost
that way.
In life. You've lost.
You should not refer to me that way.
I don't want to be on a loser team.
Well, I'm not the one who sounds gay.
I don't sound gay either.
I'm not the one who has a victim mentality.
Okay.
You're a grown man.
Thank you.
Stop crying like a little fucking baby.
Okay, I'll stop crying, because I'm crazy. I'm just insane.
Your I'm sister would be happy person. To help you.
And you're the reasonable one.
How are you going to succeed in life?
And grovel at your feet and kiss your toes. And then we'll talk. And then even then, you'll just use it like what Gracie does. You just rip her to shreds every day, no matter what she does.
And she does not claim to be a victim.
She should just fucking leave. She should leave. It's ridiculous what goes on between you two. You're just disgusting people.
Okay, so what part of this am I supposed to respect, John?
I didn't say you have to respect any part of this. I'm just telling you, I don't respect anything you're doing now. I honestly don't really care. I just don't really care. What is there here that I'm supposed to respect? That you put me in. It sucks.
You're a victim of me.
I'm not a victim of you. You've just put me in an awful situation.
John, I don't ask anything of you.
Yeah, exactly. You don't ask anything of me. You just make me pay $550 a month to live with my two brothers who hate me because you programmed them to hate me. That's fun. I love doing that. As if this is like, now this is like the family place. This is where the whole family hangs out, right? Hey. That's good. Good. I love it. You should be grateful to me for getting you out of your... Thank you so much for giving me an apartment that you took away from me immediately when you gave it to me. Thank you.
John, what I don't understand is you are perfectly free to leave from all the
harm. I'm not, Ben. You can't get an apartment when you're 18 just like that. And I have a two-year lease, or somebody has a two-year lease. You lied about the papers because you're crazy, as if that's helpful. Maybe you should just tell me what you wrote on those lease papers instead of lying to me and making me pay half the rent every month. You withhold my renting information. I have no idea what situation I'm in. And then whenever you feel like it, you can blow up my phone and ask me to come down there whenever you feel like it and like threaten my living situation that I hate, threaten everything, ruin my life.
John, whenever you feel like it. John, you have crazy. John, you have now have five cats up there.
Yes, Ben, you know why I have five cats? Because you invited every piece of your family to come over, and my cat escaped because everybody leaves the fucking door open.
I didn't get my cat pregnant. You did. His cat got pregnant.
All of this stuff you're doing right now, you're going to have to do a 180 on. It totally fucking sucks.
Okay, thank you. You're God. You're God.
It comes from the bowels.
I don't think she's having an incestuous relationship with the father. She said she hadn't had a long-term relationship, remember? If I had to guess based on, and this is very, very, very early and very preemptive, I had to guess based on what I've seen so far. My guess is that her dad is probably really abusive. But she's like, her way of kind of like coping or dealing with that is to, he's basically become her kind of like idol thing, or she's looking up to a lot of what he's saying. And then in turn, the positive feedback loop is like, maybe he abuses her a bit less or whatever. And then she just becomes like basically a little mini clone of him. That's like very like preemptive, but maybe, maybe not. I'm not sure. I can't tell. These are like very brief interactions I'm seeing. So I could be off on a lot there, but that's kind of what it seems like right now, is that she's going to be like a little mini machine that's copying a lot of his opinions. Because of the way that he's kind of like treated them growing up. But also, I have no idea. This is very, very, very preemptive, but we'll see.
My living situation.
This is how the devil talks.
Now you're going to threaten my living situation once again. Thank you, Ben. You hate all of the members of your family because you think everybody's against you in life. You think you're the mega victim.
Everybody hates you.
All of your sons hate you. Oh, poor me. My sons hate me. That's why they love me. Oh, they hate me so much. So does my wife. Oh, so does my other daughter. Oh, you know, everybody's against me. I'm a little bitch boy. You can cry about it on the internet all day. Oh, poor me. Baby. You're like a baby. That's what a baby does. Cries about how his wife
out of it. It's just unbelievable.
Have wrong.
You think most people respond her way in her situation, or is this some special thing in her brain making her submit? No, it's probably, it's just this normal like parent-child thing, right? People respond to different, to abusive parents in different ways. But like most of, like she probably doesn't even see it as abuse, right? It also makes more sense. I have to be really careful because I'm like psychoanalyzing, or I'm like mind reading a lot here. But like a lot of the way that she's analyzing the Crowder stuff makes sense for that not being abusive, because she probably sees a lot of her father's behaviors in the way that Crowder interacts. Actually, her father probably does a lot worse. But if she were to acknowledge that Crowder is abusive in some ways, she'd have to acknowledge her father is abusive in some ways. Who did I talk to the other day about this on my stream of my chat? Was it the Indian guy, Scribal? About how I actually think there's like a weird double standard. I haven't thought about this too much, so I might, by the way, I might 180 this completely. There's just a feeling I have that I haven't spent a lot of time putting into words. But I feel like people have a weird thing where their parents are their gods. And even if we verbalize the opposite, we truly don't feel that way. A really, really good example. Have we watched this on stream before? I feel like this is a really good example of this. So this guy is like coming into town. This is Will's dad. He comes into town to hang out with Will, and Will's really excited because he hasn't seen his dad very much. And now his dad's finally ready to take Will and go travel around the world with him, basically.
Lou, if you walk out of Will's life now, don't you ever come back.
Sit down.
I ain't got time for no lecture.
I said sit down, Lou. You know, Will was doing just fine until you showed up. But now that you're back, you have responsibilities to him.
Look, we're still gonna take the trip.
Oh, bull! Bull! Will is not a coat that you hang in the closet, then pick it up when you're ready to wear it. His life goes on. He's not supposed to be here for you. You're supposed to be here for him.
You get off my back! You think I want this? It just happened! Now, when Will was a baby, I was scared.
Cut the crap, all right? Cut it! Because I've been there. But I didn't run out on my family. I was there every day for them, because that's what a man does.
Fine, Philip. You win. You the man. You a better man than me. You happy? Now, you gonna tell Will or not?
I'm not gonna do your dirty work for you.
Fine. I'll call him from the road.
Yeah, then why don't you do that?
Yeah, I'll do that. Daddy-o! What's up? Will, damn it, I'm glad you're here. Some business came up I gotta handle. So we're gonna have to put our trip on hold. You understand?
Yeah. Yeah, that's cool. That's cool.
Just for a couple of weeks.
Mm-hmm, I understand. Yeah.
Maybe a little longer.
Yeah, whatever. Whatever.
Look, I'll call you next week and we'll iron out the details. Mm-hmm. Okay?
Yeah, yeah.
It was great seeing you, son.
You too, Lou.
Yeah,
I'm sorry, Will.
You know what? Actually, this works out better for me. You know, the slimmies of summer come to class wearing next to nothing. You know what I'm
Will,
saying?
Will, it's all right to be angry.
Hey, well, why should I be mad? I'm saying, at least he said goodbye this time. I just wish I hadn't wasted my money buying this stupid present.
I'm sorry. You know, if there was something that I
could. Hey, you know what? You ain't got to do nothing, Uncle Phil. Hey, you know, ain't like I'm still 5 years old, you know? Ain't like I'm gonna be sitting up every night asking my mom, when's daddy coming home, you know? Who needs him? Hey, he wasn't there to teach me how to shoot my first basket, but I learned, didn't I? Hey, I got pretty damn good at it too, didn't I,
yeah,
Uncle Phil?
You did.
Got through my first day without him, right? Mm. I learned how to drive, I learned how to shave, I learned how to fight without him. I had 14 great birthdays without him. He never even sent me a damn card. To hell with him! I ain't need him then, and I don't need him now.
Will.
Now, you know what, Uncle Phil? I'm gonna get through college without him. I'm gonna get a great job without him. I'm gonna marry me a beautiful honey, and I'm having me a whole bunch of kids. I'm gonna be a better father than he ever was. And I sure as hell don't need him for that, because ain't a damn thing he could ever teach me about how to love my kids. How come he don't want me, man?
Rip. I feel like a lot of, but I know that we had that discussion where somebody said that, I think we had a disagreement over how people's trauma with their parents manifest. But I truly do feel like a lot of people, because I've talked to people, like good, successful people, well into their 30s even, that are doing good in life, and they still carry with them like some kind of like attachment issue with parents. It's very, 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 very hard to see your parents as being flawed, even if you hate them, even if you say you hate them, even if you, even if you like, oh, I'm blah, blah, blah. Like, it seems like people, it, like outwardly it might manifest that way, but like internally they still have a really huge problem getting over it. But I might be reaching, but now it makes sense why she was so insistent on having you can see that the Crowder stuff wasn't abusive before ending the combo. Yeah, sure, because you can't, it's very hard to accept fault in your parents. It's very, very, very difficult to do it.
Him his whole life. That's what he does. Little baby. Baby, baby, dad. How his sons and his wife wronged him for the rest of his life because he's a quote-unquote traditional guy who's got himself together. Yeah, right, Ben.
Yes, I'm a great
guy. You're a traditional guy. That's why you...
I'm a great guy.
That's why all of your children, you don't talk to any of them.
Right,
you
because
hate
you
them because they're against
you.
You right?
won't let me talk.
Oh,
why won't you let your father talk to you? Why won't you let your father talk to you?
Why
won't you let your father talk to you? Why won't you let your father talk to you?
Throw it in their face all the time.
Fucking
nice
burn in hell, you fucking
your
asshole.
Your daughter and your son are
Jesus
nice people,
Christ.
And you hate them.
May you rot in hell for.
What a baby. Yeah, Ben rage quitted, and so did his daughter.
John,
hear it.
John, don't you think this is exactly what mom wants? Is you screaming
yes,
at dad?
Because everything has to do with your dynamics between your parents. That's what your entire life should be centered around, Gracie. I'm not like you, Gracie. I don't center my entire life around the.
Something else. Oh fuck. We should spend. Oh, I bet this family is really interesting for abuse dynamics. Another really effective way. My grandma did a lot of this with me and my sister. And in retrospect, I can see a lot of manipulation tactics that she used. But at the time, I was just like a fucking... I think I spent until from like 8 years old to like 12 years old with her. Like almost every weekend I'd go over. So it was I didn't see it as a kid because I'm a dumb fuck. Because I'm a kid. I have an excuse to be a dumb fuck. One really effective manipulation tactic when it comes from children is to have a child... When you have your child, you externalize every bad thought that they have on the enemy parent. So if you're a dad or a mom and you're trying to get it, you're trying to take advantage of your child, anytime you run into issues or anytime they're having doubts or a problem, you always externalize that problem to the other parent. What they just said, what she just said right there, like, don't you think this is what mom wants? Like anytime you have an issue, it's because mom is saying this. Mom is trying to make you feel this way. It's because mom is turning you against me. It's because mom is the one that said this thing. That's why you feel this way, right? And it's a very easy way to kind of like mind fuck somebody into thinking like, yeah, if I have an issue, it is with the other parent. You're right. And I trust you. I think you're guiding me well. You're telling me like as an authority figure, super, super, super easy to turn somebody against somebody else that way. If that's what's going on. So this is a little bit, this is a little premature, to be fair, because I haven't seen much, but this is like what it's pointing that direction of. I think I'm probably going to leave in within 30 minutes because I got to go see Dan. So.
Dynamics of my older parents. 20 years old and all you do is cry about how your mommy doesn't feed you enough or something. 20 years old, you can't do anything with your life. Fucking
you
loser.
Literally just said
why don't you go find a man who
enough.
Will like
you
who will like
beat
you? Because I think that's
you
the only way that you will be happy in life is if you have a guy who tells you to shut the fuck up and stop crying about your mommy all the time, because that's not what everybody's
God,
like
you
about.
Literally
that's
just
what
scream,
that's what people who have no like rethinking do. They just attribute everything to other people in their
are you
life.
Ever stop?
Everything is your
are
fault.
You,
everything is your fault. Everything is your fault.
Are you
oh,
ever
mommy,
stop?
Everything
please,
is your
do
fault.
Not
I
do
never
this.
Change. Oh,
don't do this.
Okay, you got me. I won't do this anymore. You won. You're the alpha. You won. Nobody can hear you. You muted yourself. Don't you think Ben has like a gay way of sitting and looking? It's just gay. I don't know how to say it. Like, you're not like the like manly looking guy here. You're like looking at your screen like a little princess.
Jesus.
Snooty. All snooty. Got your nose turned up because you're better than this. With your gay little hat on that I bought you as a Father's Day gift because I hate you so much.
looking at your screen, looking at me, hating me.
You do die of starvation. I hope you die of starvation, and I hope you are thrown out of that apartment.
Oh my God.
Yep. Good, thank you.
I'll go to the landlord right now.
What did I do in this apartment? Did I jerk off or something? I don't know what I did. What did I do?
You have five cats in that apartment.
I can tell my landlord that, and I'll tell my landlord that you're living downstairs like a fucking weirdo, smoking his fucking apartment away. That's not even an apartment. It's a commercial space, buddy.
You don't live down here. I'll be living up there.
Yeah, you do, buddy. Yeah, well, you live down here right now, and you're smoking away.
You want to go? You want to go?
No, I don't want to go.
John, you have been unbelievably irresponsible up there, John.
How? What have I done? I don't know
I'm
why
gonna come up there and beat the fucking shit out of you. God. I'm going to beat the fucking shit out of you.
Oh, my God.
I'm going to beat your fucking knee, so you'll need another surgery.
Cool guy. Cool guy. You're a cool guy,
I will.
Man.
Yes, I will.
You're
I think
the alpha.
Twice.
You're the alpha. You know
Shut
what?
Your
if
mouth.
I die that way, then so be it. I hope you rot in hell for saying that. Because I don't know what you're saying,
Stop
but that's not a nice thing to say. I never said I was going to physically assault you and beat your broken knee.
Yes, you should never do that to your father. But,
but you should never do that to your son, buddy. You're not like a traditional man who's like a cool guy and he told his son
he's going
to beat
on Discord.
His ass.
Yeah,
you're not
they can
a
listen
cool
to
guy, buddy.
Cry, and as I beat
your
fucking head,
failed, lights the cigarettes like a faggot. No offense, but you do. Your whole like smoking thing is gay
now
too.
It's no offense. No offense. Oh, thank you so
That's
much.
That's the joke. But
you're not being offensive
because you're a cringy boomer. But gay. I don't know. You're the way you like just picked at your lip is gay.
Boot this
yeah, boot me. This is. I really care. I really care. Thank you, Ben, for letting me talk shit about you.
You get lost.
Oh, thank you.
Unless you can behave. You want to behave?
No. I don't know what behaving means. Act like Grace?
Shoot yourself,
Should I
Ben.
Act like Grace? Should I act like Grace? Would that be behaving?
Yes.
Be your little slave, weirdo slave girl? Because that's what she
don't
is. She's your weirdo little slave
So you're
girl.
Here to talk to your dad. Right, but you won't let him talk. Can you let me talk now? Okay, enough speech.
This is a Discord call. You don't have anything else to do in your day. This does not
I don't
want to
listen to your insolence. I do not.
What do you have to do all day? What are you going to do after this? Cry in your bed?
I do not want. I don't have to listen to your horse shit.
Okay. Yeah, you don't. You can
You're
18 me whenever
years
you
old.
Want. You have
to I never have to talk to
right
you
now.
Again. I never have to talk to you again. You can go
I would love that. You don't talk to me anyways.
Go,
the
go
only
ahead.
Time you
go.
Do talk to me is
go.
When you quote-unquote quote, ask
Goodbye.
For help.
Go ahead. Go ahead. Do it. Follow through. Go
okay.
ahead. Flip off. Fuck you. Never come back. Go
okay.
move away. Fuck you.
Okay.
Try
you got
to someone
buddy.
Else. Fuck you. Fuck you.
You got me, buddy. You
Go
won.
Ahead, blip off, big guy.
I never said I'm going to blip off myself. You were the one
you
who said
you're
never going to
talk
to me again.
Again.
I never
Go
said
ahead
I was
and follow
talk
through,
you
faggot.
See, this is
Jesus
what.
Jesus Christ.
You're just such a hypocrite. You're the one who said you were going to never talk to me again. I never said that about you.
Yes, you did.
No, I just said that if
I
that
said,
is the
I
way
never
was...
have to talk to you again. And you said, oh, I'd love that. So go love it.
Well, why don't you go love it?
Get lost, call a taxi, and never talk to me again.
You were the one who threatened it.
Goodbye.
Okay, buddy. You were the one who threatened it in the first place, Alpha Wolf.
Goodbye. Go cry to someone else. I don't want to hear it.
Why would an alpha guy dress like you and smoke like you?
Oh, my God.
You're not an alpha. You're a wannabe
I don't
want to
hear it. So
you know,
get lost.
Okay, I'll give you my psychoanalysis of you. You're a wannabe.
If you hopped on this
My
Team Crazy, but this family's fucked up. Oh,
of
sorry.
A beta earlier in his life, and he figured out that was a loser
analysis
to
of me or anything else.
Now he's trying
Go
to be
away
a cool
and never come back.
Guy, and I think you should just give up the act and act like a nice guy, which you are, instead of a.
Oh, and I bet she picked up the smoking from her father too. True.
Cute. It was.
Big break.
My dad helped me so much. You wouldn't.
She really does sound 100% like Jade, right?
Believe it's like, I want both of us to blow up. He helped me so much. I was so nervous. I was like,
oh, and her dad helped her prepare. It makes so much sense.
It was big break. My dad helped me so much. You wouldn't believe it's like, I want both of us to blow up. He helped me so much. I was so nervous. I was like, ah.
Imagine having a debate where the person that's abusing you is trying to convince you that somebody else isn't being abusive, which is my perspective, right? Jesus.
You could see you could crush him, but like winning the debate.
Who's this guy?
You know, necessarily what it's about for him. You know, you got the your entertainment aspect to the crowd, the various value propositions for people watching versus the actual argument. But I think you saw that.
Holy Jesus.
Crazed. A fucking irrational alpha retard, and I think you're trying to cover up something. I don't know.
I don't think
what have I ever done to you that we're
I don't think I'm siding with my mom. It's just that my mom is the only person that can help me in a real way. I don't know what to tell you.
Loser, faggot, mouth sometimes.
I can't talk. You get to control how I talk because you're the alpha. Okay, I get it. Whenever you feel like it, you can hold your hand up and say, stop talking. And they get angry when I don't stop talking. I get it. You're the alpha of the world.
John.
You beat everybody.
And I bet when she, remember how she said she talked, she dropped out of high school? I bet she didn't drop out. I bet her dad made her drop out. Guess, that's a total guess, but. Wait, is there a glitch that makes it so when you click, the moves don't appear? Oh.
Everybody here, because everybody, if you gave them a chance, would disappoint you. And then you'd scream at them and ask them to apologize like you did to Daniel.
Okay, you can talk and then I can talk. How about that for a rule?
Is you talk at me and that's not a good thing.
John, you are bringing damnation onto your head by doing what you're doing.
Yes, God hates me, right? God hates me. I think God loves
God
me.
God hates what you're doing.
I don't worry about God right now.
God loves you,
life.
But God hates
what
you're
doing
right now.
Yeah, well, I don't think I'm condemning myself with anything I say.
I think you are.
You're wrong for using that against people all the time as if you're God.
Oh, brother, I was just going to pause and say that, but that's another, it could be another avenue for abuse too. She said that they were Catholic. Presenting yourself as hyper-religious and then saying that the things you say are the things that God wills is also an interesting way to, like, manipulate a person, right? Like, you can't disobey me. This is literally, like, what God would say, basically, right?
You're not God. You're not the prophet of God. You shouldn't use that as a way to say you're going to go to hell whenever you feel like it. I think the way you've treated
you
me
are
has come up
doing
to get
evil.
You to hell in a way.
You are you doing evil now. Stop doing evil.
The way you've acted towards
Stop
me, at least.
Stop doing evil. Stop it. Woman and I talk
I
to
don't
a man.
Talk like an angry woman. You talk
yes,
like
you
an angry woman.
Is this guy's YouTube video just this whole conversation or Jesus?
In his life. That's what you
should
like.
Do this. You should
well,
not
you
face
act,
up
saying,
like that.
That's what you act
You
like.
Are bringing damnation
that's
onto yourself
you
by doing
like,
this.
Saying,
shut up.
Don't be such a bitch.
Shut up.
Ryan Dawson is on Fresh and Fit. Oh my God. Sneeko got him the connect. Ryan Dawson's revival into relevancy through Sneeko, right? Nice.
Rick Weinstein pointed it out. He basically hinted his two favorite countries, right? Like the U.S. and the other one.
Jesus.
Shut your fat fucking faggot mouth for 1 minute.
Yes, you're acting a little hysterical right now, Ben. It's very womanly.
You're a bitch, obviously, too. If you, after this 20 minutes, you say, I'm the one who's spurging. You are a little bitch boy.
You are the one who's spurging. You always spurg because you're a baby and you use, like, quote unquote, etiquette of conversation as your way of spurging. And it's not. You're so scared of me.
Right. Jeffrey Dahmer is on your side, John. All right.
Yeah.
Pursue it with him. You will find that he is not someone.
Everybody's
you
on my side.
Want to assist. No, that's not.
Jeffrey Dahmer is a good guy.
A video that Grace made about her mom. A short clip from my mom's last stream. 51 years old, 6 children, absolutely batshit crazy. Why is her name AKA Joanne? Or why is she Grace Thorpe AKA Joanne? Is it, do they have like biblical names?
Hey,
Oh, Joanne. Joan, not Joan, sorry.
It's from the 80s, just ahead.
What is this?
I'm a really good guy.
He is. Yeah, but it's not clear that he isn't also trolling at the same time. But whatever.
I'm not trolling John. I think John is 100% right about your family.
You
he's
think
the
that
only
he's
one
been
of you that is sane.
He's been.
He doesn't need to be respectful to you.
Okay, so you don't.
There's
think
no
that
reason for him to respect you.
He's going
to
do the same thing.
No,
as
son
you,
should
right?
respect their father, but you haven't been a father to your son, so why should Ooh. He respect you?
Right. Okay. I think a son should always respect his father, and I think that anyone who says otherwise.
Yeah, we know you think this because you hate your own father, and you have this.
I do not hate my father, and I respect him.
I don't know how you could say anything else.
No.
Okay, you don't like him very much.
He is in the clutches of. I can't talk though, right? I can't talk. Can we say?
That's not how you talk to people. That's not
John,
how you talk
can,
to people.
Okay,
I'm sorry.
Okay, now you're talking. You're saying how to talk to people.
Hey, you just freak out.
Are you
out
interested in
talk.
Listening to anyone other than yourself screaming?
Talk. You can talk over me if you want. And then it's mostly when you're on a Discord call because we're not in person. It's kind of hard to know the cues. So sometimes it's better to just talk over somebody until they shut up. Yes, that's how it works sometimes on a Discord call.
Sometimes that works. Sometimes you listen to other people.
Yes, but it's kind of hard.
Okay, four more minutes and I'm leaving, okay?
Talking when it's so low.
Here's a suggestion. Why don't you shut your fucking mouth for a few minutes?
That's not very respectful to the conversation.
Yes.
Yelling that at somebody. I'm not a little kid anymore. You shouldn't yell that
shut
at me.
Shut your fucking mouth for a few minutes.
That's called ad hominem.
Sus.
John, are you having a good time in my Discord?
Why do you keep saying that? I can leave whenever
are
I
you?
Want.
Are you? Seems like you are. Can you just say I'm having,
yeah,
a, good
I'm having a good time
in your Discord?
You.
Okay. You're enjoying yourself. Okay. Can I make a suggestion as the person who's running this Discord that maybe you just
you
take a little bit of a breather now. We get the message. You're angry and you're a victim of everything and everyone. I think everyone gets that. Maybe other people could say something. John, this guy who is allying himself with you is a complete and utter loser.
But I don't think that. Oh, Provo?
Not at the core, but like on the surface.
Provo?
He has said that he can't stay awake ever any day
Provo?
For the rest of his life. No, Snick.
Yeah, for context, Jerome, he's got like a neurological illness.
Yeah, it's called I Hate My Father.
I don't know
same
what
that you have, John.
He doesn't even have a neurological illness. He just sleeps all day anyways. Unfortunately. What way are you a religious man?
Okay, be quiet. Be quiet. Yeah, let me tell you what I'm saying. John was on Oxycontin, right? That's an opioid. He could say to me, Dad, I became hooked on Oxycontin. And I don't know the lingo.
You're,
whatever the
you're
fuck
God
it is,
boy, right?
Loser pills, okay? Loser
I
pills.
Them for a couple
are,
days. I have most
dude.
Of them saved.
A lot of people like John will say, you know, a month from now, look, I became addicted to opioids and now I'm an opioid addict. And they would say, what are you going to do about it? And I would tell him, go fuck yourself. That's what I'm going to do.
Sorry.
Hey, okay. Okay, John.
Not really that big of a host.
I don't understand why he can't just go to his Discord and do what he wants.
I can ban him. That you want me to ban him? That's easier.
Don't
all right,
ban
we'll ban
him.
You. That's fine. We'll ban him.
Bitches are.
What he wants to do. He doesn't want to be respectful. Do you want to make an? Like all these retards can go
Man,
to your Discord.
Fries are busted.
2 seconds. So why don't you go to your Discord? I don't care.
Wow, Ben killed a bunch of PCs.
You
right
muted
now.
Yourself. Dad.
I'll be quiet. I'll be quiet. It's more, I just want to listen.
No, I don't want you here.
Look. Guys, stop with the gay
Okay, he's still here. Do you want him here? Do you? I can ban him.
Damn
I can
it,
kick him.
My...
Next, we'll take a look at Ben and Grace's relationship. It was very common when the Thorpes were doing voice calls.
Okay. I gotta go see my good friend Dan the Man. And hope to God this family won't be the end of me. Oh man. I can resist, okay? I believe in myself. All right. You can watch one more minute? No, I need to go see Dan. And Melina's dad is leaving tomorrow too, so we're like eating food and everything, okay?